According to Minister Akello, the developer, after acquiring the land, was issued with land agreement which he used to solicit funds from business community, but the progress has since stalled. Those who paid money are in dilemma, as Minister Akello calls for investigations into the giveaway of Arua Hill Bomber Ground land and alleged extortion of funds from business community by the developer.
In the city, but fraudulently, without following any procedure. And because of this arrangement which has not followed procedure, government doesn't have anything to the stadium. The private developer went ahead because nobody is guiding him after getting the land fraudulently from Arua municipality. Then he went using the land that he has got, or the land agreement that he has got, from the municipal council and started soliciting funds.
During the official launch of the project on May 8, 2019, the developer disclosed that it would cost shillings 30 billion to construct Arua Hill Stadium and Business Center. On the fateful day, the former officials of Arua Municipal Council, led by the then Deputy RDC Arua Ali Sakelo, the former Member of Parliament Wadri Kasiano, and the former LC5 Vice Chairperson Genesis Atema, on Wednesday, May 8, 2019, at the Bomber Ground, broke the grounds for the construction of Arua Hill Stadium.
And the community now, they are crying. They don't know even where to go to, because you come to the city authority, they don't have any document which is legally binding.
As part of the project, Development Infrastructure promised to construct a new classroom block at Arua Hill Primary School, with renovation of the old classrooms at shillings 300 million, which has not been done to date. The head teacher of Arua Hill Primary School, Beatrice Asimasia Adiru, explains the challenges faced with only shillings 11 million UPE capitation grant, which cannot renovate the dilapidated school structures.
The school classroom is now old. They are dilapidated. They in fact need either a new classroom or a serious facelift. But this has not been done.
This has also crippled sports activities for the children of Arua Hill, whose Bomber Ground was given without alternative playground for the learners.
Our greatest challenge instead for the stadium is, one, they have deprived the children from the playground, and right now the only space where the children can use for play are the openings, the roads within.
The head teacher expressed worry over snakes and the risks associated with the bushy environment adjacent to the school for the learners.
And the greatest challenge is now behind. The borderline between the school and the stadium is bushy, and it has inhabited very big snakes. When they come out, they're a threat to the children, and you find children running all over.
The delay to complete the facility greatly affected the pupils of Arua Hill, who performed poorly in sports.
Yeah, we are doing badly. Even in the last tournament, we did not make it. Although our girls went up to finals, but our boys were eliminated in group stages. So with the football, they need ample practice.
When contacted on phone, Sunday Olise, one of the directors of Development Infrastructure, could not respond to his call to make a response. The 8-acre land has since been occupied with the various unfinished structures. A report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.